It's happening. Hillary could finally be arrested after what Trump just tweeted once he got his account back. Every American who voted for President Trump has been waiting to see what would happen to his former opponent. One would think that after the scandal that has surrounded Hillary Clinton, she would want to stay out of the spotlight, but that doesn't seem to be the case. The former First Lady is doing everything she can to keep America stirred up about the president. However, the more Hillary points to some sort of wrongdoing on the part of the president, the more it looks like she was to blame all along. Every piece of evidence that is brought up about collusion with outside entities during the 2016 presidential election has backfired on the Democratic Party and ultimately points back to Hillary and her supporters. Today, though, Americans got a glimmer of hope that we might see justice after all. President Trump tweeted this after his Twitter account was mysteriously taken offline and then reinstated. Donna Brazile just stated the DNC rigged the system to illegally steal the primary from Bernie Sanders. Bought and paid for by crooked H. This is real collusion and dishonesty. Major violation of campaign finance laws and money laundering, where is our Justice Department? This was tweeted just hours after the president found that his Twitter account had been deactivated. The controversial social media account has been no end of pain and suffering for Democrats who depend on the left-leaning media to spin the public perception of everyone, including presidents. However, President Trump decided that he needed a tool to talk directly to the American people, and Twitter has been that tool. According to the BBC, an employee deactivated at Donald Trump during their last day on the job. The account was offline for about 11 minutes, and Twitter has since launched an investigation. Twitter said it was investigating the problem and taking steps to avoid it happening again. It later said, "Through our investigation, we have learned that this was done by a Twitter customer support employee who did this on the employee's last day. We are conducting a full internal review." Every American who voted for President Trump has been waiting to see what would happen to his former opponent. One would think that after the scandal that has surrounded Hillary Clinton, she would want to stay out of the spotlight, but that doesn't seem to be the case. The former First Lady is doing everything she can to keep America stirred up about the president. However, the more Hillary points to some sort of wrongdoing on the part of the president, the more it looks like she was to blame all along. Every piece of evidence that is brought up about collusion with outside entities during the 2016 presidential election has backfired on the Democratic Party and ultimately points back to Hillary and her supporters. Today, though, Americans got a glimmer of hope that we might see justice after all. President Trump tweeted this after his Twitter account was mysteriously taken offline and then reinstated. Donna Brazile just stated the DNC rigged the system to illegally steal the primary from Bernie Sanders. Bought and paid for by crooked H. This is real collusion and dishonesty. Major violation of campaign finance laws and money laundering, where is our Justice Department? This is real collusion and dishonesty. Major violation of campaign finance laws and money laundering, where is our Justice Department? This was tweeted just hours after the president found that his Twitter account had been deactivated. The controversial social media account has been no end of pain and suffering for Democrats who depend on the left-leaning media to spin the public perception of everyone, including presidents. However, President Trump decided that he needed a tool to talk directly to the American people, and Twitter has been that tool. According to the BBC, an employee deactivated at Donald Trump during their last day on the job. The account was offline for about 11 minutes, and Twitter has since launched an investigation. Twitter said it was investigating the problem and taking steps to avoid it happening again. It later said, "Through our investigation, we have learned that this was done by a Twitter customer support employee who did this on the employee's last day. We are conducting a full internal review." So what exactly is this issue that the president was so ready to tell Americans about, and why does he think the media won't tell us? According to Daily Wire, one of the Democratic Party's top politicians has jumped ship and is telling all their dirty secrets, especially Hillary's. Maybe she realized that the ship was going down and wanted to find some leverage to keep her from coming under fire, or maybe she's just not a very loyal person and found a way to make a buck, but Donna Brazile, The former Democratic National Committee head has let out secrets that can never be gotten back, and it might just take down crooked Hillary once and for all. Former Democratic National Committee head Donna Brazile is coming out with a new tell-all book about the chaos at the DNC during the 2016 campaign. On Thursday, she revealed a section of it at Politico. What emerges from the excerpt is a picture of Brazile's heroine. Of course, Hillary Clinton is villainous, Debbie Wasserman Schultz as incompetent and lazy, and Barack Obama as the unnamed cancer that ate away at the center of the party. Brazile portrays herself as a Hercule Poirot sussing out malfeasance at the DNC, then stealing herself with God and soul to inform the unfortunate Bernie Sanders that he had been jobbed. Before I called Bernie Sanders, I lit a candle in my living room and put on some gospel music, Brazile writes. I wanted to center myself for what I knew would be an emotional phone call. This comes from the same lady who leaked debate questions to Hillary Clinton to disadvantage Sanders. As if talking about the entire Democratic Party wasn't enough to put someone inside the literal crosshairs of some of the most dangerous people in the United States, she also gets specific about Hillary, our former almost president of the United States. We might have dodged a bullet by not electing Hillary, but it's doubtful that Brazile will be able to dodge whatever the Clintons send after her. Hillary used that debt to pick up power. They pledged to fill in the funding gap for the DNC so long as they got to run operations. Gary Gensler, CFO of the Hillary campaign, apparently described the party as fully under the control of Hillary's campaign, which seemed to confirm the suspicions of the Bernie camp. The campaign had the DNC on life support, giving it money every month to meet its basic expenses, while the campaign was using the party as a fundraising clearinghouse. Hillary raised an enormous amount of money for the DNC, but virtually all that money went to Hillary's campaign. Less than half of 1% of all money Hillary raised from her fundraisers went to the states, Brazile explains. When the Politico story described this arrangement as essentially money laundering for the Clinton campaign, Hillary's people were outraged at being accused of doing something shady. Bernie's people were angry for their own reasons, saying this was part of a calculated strategy to throw the nomination to Hillary. While we can take hope in the idea that the backward and crooked nature of the DNC might finally be coming to light, make no mistake, if the DNC as we know it does crumble, that doesn't mean the evil people will go away. If the DNC is no more, there's no doubt that something even more sinister will rise from the ashes, / like some sort of perpetually destructive phoenix. The fight is not over, it's only just beginning.